I, today Sterdon, yes, the Boeing vertical axis gyroscope. So, it is this big box. We have at the bottom part the electronics pack with the one connector. The two pieces, the gyro container and the electronics, are bolted together. Here are the details. For you, it seems it received quite a lot of modifications because the letters are stuck to the P or Q letter here, well before R, so it was modified quite a few times. You can see the weight, the serial number, quite a big one, made by Sperry in Phoenix, Arizona, and it is quite fun, this manufacturer label is actually bolted in place, so there is a warranty sticker here. Interesting, here we have what seems to be some settings. You can access with a screwdriver and you can turn probably a multi-rotary switches, but there is no label or whatsoever to explain what they do. And this must be some light, maybe even a LED, not sure. So on the bottom there is just a plate with nuts, with bolts and screws. And you can see this whole thing is more or less heat sink. So on the top the over stickers, handle tenderly, very tenderly. Delicate instrument, repair tag from BF Goodrich Aerospace in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. It was repaired in 1995, and one handle with care. And apart from that, it is all. Now I can remove the top cover. Okay, so actually I did already open it because I was too curious and I could not wait. So it was under vacuum. It is why you have all these nuts, these screws all around. There was a seal. There is a seal even. And here must be the vacuum filling port, or air emptying rather. There is a little nut, a little screw in the middle. And there is a valve, it seems, inside, and it is a Bristol spline screw, so it is a lock. I did order these keys, because if I want to put again vacuum in it, it will be necessary. So, what do we have inside? Will it be very beautiful? Will it be boring? Ta-da! So I remove this piece here, and I lift the cover. So the inside of the cover is pretty much empty. And here is what we have, guys. It can turn like this for hours. It seems we have very good bearings. So by the looks of it, it is a quite simple gyroscope. We don't have a great deal of cables going here, just a few of them. So you can see it is mounted in this very serious die-cast aluminium piece and bolted in this shock absorbers. I do not know the purpose of the little plates here, and it is quite weird in fact because this one is straight, but the other ones are bent. I'm sure if you can see, they are not straight the other ones, but they have a cell model number. So I do not know what is the deal with it. So about the gyroscope part, we have rotary contacts either side. Here. We have this axis with one kind of motor or resolver thing here. Synchro resolving thing, but probably. synchro transmitter even, which says which is the current position of gyro. We have a second axis here, and this one can only turn a little bit. There is this plate here, which is actually the stop. And it is a little bit springy, so it will not stop too hard. And this screw here must be for precise balancing. And of course, in this part, we have a gyroscopic wheel. Three wires going inside here, probably for the motor of the wheel. And on the other side, we have five wires. Yes, so it may be a synchro transmitter also at this part. We have one in here also. And in fact, it is all for this part, except that it is very beautiful, as you can see. And it will turn like so for a very, very long time. So I will not take this further apart because it is probably very delicate and we already see most of the parts except for the gyro wheel inside, but we know already what it looks like, so there is no real point of disturbing the thing. So of course it is imperial screws everywhere. So I will replace the top cover and we will have a look at the electronics pack. So to separate the electronics pack, it is just a matter of undoing 8 screws all around. And it will nicely separate into parts with just one connector and one ground strap to undo. So I will do it and will be right back. So here we are. I did already disconnect the connectors here. So it is why it is not connected. It is perfectly normal. So I put aside the gyro part. So the gyro module, the bottom side is exactly like the top, except that it is not painted and there is one connector here. So what do we have here? It is pretty crowded, but we see almost everything. I have a stack of 3 PCBs here, but I believe they will probably be more or less the same thing. So I am not sure if it is necessary to undo it or not. I will see. So maybe, yes. In fact, it is just one time I take it apart, so I can do it. So while I am doing this, you can see on the top, on this here, the very nice wire looms. Very, very nicely made. In here we have probably power supply components. You can, not sure if you will see at the bottom here, but there is cork wood components here. And there is actually the body of two multi-way contacts, rotary contacts, you can turn to adjust things. Here is the what I did believe was a light indicator, but it is a magnetic white and black dot indicator, it seems. Here, potted modules, probably transformers, some rectifiers and capacitors over here for probably for the power supply needs. So, excuse me, I am trying to find correct tools to do it. So it looks like there is a stack of 3 PCBs. So these PCBs on the side, I see we have not sure if I will be able to remove one easily. Maybe this one should not be too difficult. So we'll try to undo this one here, because I see a lot of round ices. But for now, here, I have some screws to undo. They are pretty long, and I hope I will be able to lift the top PCB and have a look at the two other ones. Oops, one drop washer, two drop washers even. I did find another one at the bottom. So I will undo the screws and I will be right back. Okay, so I did unscrew first the PCB on the side here. The other one looks the same, so we will only have a look at one. We have a whole row of transistors mounted on this heatsink. And there is a screw at the end of each transistor, quite nice to keep in place these springy things. Round ICs here, FSL 20312, that code of 1974 or 75. So it must be the vintage of this device, and you can see very small resistors all the way. Diodes, resistors, maybe some capacitors also. So pretty simple, big one here. And there is no connection, no connector to this PCB, everything is hard. Voilà. And here the sandwich of three PCBs. So there is another thing put here at the bottom. Round with probably toroidal transformer. So the sandwich of PCBs, you can see the very nice wire loom. The first PCB can lift off. We have this 1000 grade capacitance, tantalum capacitance maybe, 11 microfarad at 10%, 15 volts. We have a bunch of precision resistors and some transistors. One IC here and here, four power transistors. Oops, it is out of the frame. 2N3767, date code of 1974, made by Motorola. Okay, if I flip it, second layer. Oops, try not to damage anything if possible. We have two ceramic ICs, SL6603 and 04. We have the transistor in heat sinks, and more of the same parts, in fact, nothing very fancy, exactly the same stuff. And the last layer of PCB is more of the same stuff, with one more weird reference IC. And this one is still actually screwed to the bottom plate of the case. One more transistor by Motorola here, and it is written two times the reference for some reason. And in fact it is all. So you can see here the Teflon insulators for the components mounted on these metal plates. And it is in fact all for this thing. So it is quite pretty. I was expecting more electronics, in fact, and more complicated gyro, but you cannot know what you will find. And actually, this part is still available, still cost a lot of money on US eBay, so maybe it is still in service in some airliners, because they are worth between $200 and $1,000. So I got mine for a very good price, so I will not complain. Okay, I hope you did enjoy this gyro teardown. It would be nice if I was able to power it, but first I need to find the documentation with the pinouts and so. It may not be easy, but it is probably making an awesome noise when powered on. For now, I will put this back together. So, thanks for watching and stay tuned for more stuff. Bye bye.